Right, in this video, I want to show you the basics of hypothesis testing for the non-traditional method, or the p-value method, to be more specific. All right, the p-value method. I have shown in a separate video the basics of hypothesis testing using the traditional method. So there are two different kinds. Actually, probably more than two, but I'm only showing you two in my videos. So real quickly here, the basics of hypothesis testing, no matter what method you're using, traditional or p-value, is that there are going to be two types of hypotheses, right? There's the null hypothesis and there's the alternative hypothesis. Let's see, almost every book I've used uses H sub zero or H naught as the null hypothesis, and no matter what parameter you're talking about, whether it's a proportion or a mean or a standard deviation, the null hypothesis always uses an equal sign, right? Always has an equal sign in it. The alternative hypothesis, maybe your book uses H sub 1 or H sub A, whatever the case may be, always uses a symbol that is not an equal sign, right? So in this case, it's a less than symbol or a greater than symbol or a not equal to symbol. But no matter what type of hypothesis testing it is, you will always be given some level of significance here. Okay, so whether it's 0.01 or 0.05 or 0.10, something like that. Now that level of significance is called alpha. Right? It's called alpha, which is the Greek lowercase letter A here. That's the first letter of the Greek alphabet. So, and we're not restricted to 0.01, 0.5, or 10% or something like that. It could be any other type of level of significance. But these are the three more popular ones. Okay, the other thing I want to tell you about, and keep your eye on these three alternative hypotheses here, right? So less than, greater than, or not equal to, is depending on what kind of a test we're talking about, you might have a left tail test, a right tail test, or a two tail test. And that all depends on the alternative hypothesis. So, right, so I'm using H sub 1 as my alternative hypothesis notation here. But if the alternative hypothesis is less than, we have a left tail test. If it's greater than, we have a right tail test. Or if it's not equal to, we have a two tail test. Right, we have a two tail test. So that is also important and significant here. And what do I mean by that? I didn't show this in my previous video, but for example here, let's say I've got, I got a little package here of push pins. Can you guys see that? I think you can see that in the video here now. All right, and it says that there should be 100 push pins in here. Now, if I think I got gypped, right, and I'm thinking they're putting less than 100 push pins in there, then less than would be a left tail test. All right, or maybe I'm thinking they're being generous as I buy these push pins, and they're actually putting more than 100 in. Well, more than would be a right tail test, greater than. Okay, or if I state the claim, right, all of these are claims here. If I state the claim as, I don't think they're putting 100 in there. Right? Notice I'm not specifying when I say I don't think they're putting 100 in there. I believe there aren't 100 in there. I'm not specifying whether it's less than 100 or greater than 100. So in that case, it would be a two-tailed test. So depending on the wording that you see, it could be one of those types of alternative hypotheses or claims. Okay. So what I showed again in a previous video, you could look it up, is the traditional method, and what I'm going to show you in this video is the p-value method, right? But notice I wrote on this little piece of paper here that both methods, doesn't matter which method you're using, both methods require you to find a test statistic. So both methods use a test statistic. Whether your test statistic is with proportions, that would be p hat minus p over the square root of little p times q over n, or maybe you're dealing with sample means and population means, and so your test statistic would be with this formula here. So you probably are familiar with those formulas, okay? But regardless of the method, both of them use test statistics, okay? So what the p-value does separately from the traditional method is this, right? The traditional method uses something called critical values. Right, I'll just put this on here real quick. The traditional method, uses something called critical values. Well, guess what? And I'm going to cross that out. The p-value method does not use that at all. All right, p-value method says, look, I don't really care about the critical value whatsoever. So that's kind of a nice little thing here. So let's say that, for example, we are dealing with a right tail test. Right, so I'll draw a little right tail here. Right. So let's say, for example, we were dealing with a right tail test. That's our H sub 1 is a greater than. Then what the p-value says is this. All right, what the p-value says is this. What we're going to do is we're going to find, using the formulas that I just showed you a second ago, we're going to find, put here find, we're going to find our test statistic. All right, we're going to find our test statistic using that formula you just saw on the previous page. And then we're going to put that in. I'm going to write this as how about TS, all right, test for statistic. We're gonna put that in here, and this is a right tail test. Let's say our test statistic here, I don't know, I'm just kind of making something up. But let's say our test statistic came out to be something like, how about -2.61, for example, all right? Or sorry, positive, this is on the right-hand side. So let's say our test statistic came out to 2.61. Okay, so for example here, 2.61. Now, do you see that this area, the area sitting over here to the far right of this, is 0.0045. Okay, you can look that up. This area is 0.0045, right? It's 0.0045. And you can look that up on a table if you want to, or you can use Excel to figure that area out. But here's the deal. That area is what's called our p-value. All right, so this area is the p-value now. All right, so the area sitting over here to the right, in this case of a test statistic, is our p-value. Okay, so that area, in this case 0.0045, is our p-value that we are going to compare. All right, we're going to compare the p-value to our alpha, to our level of significance, and that's how p-value method, the testing, works. So in our case, I have a p-value of 0.0045, and let's say that we had an alpha. Let's say that we were looking for a level of significance of 0.01, for example. I don't know, we'll pick on 0.01. All right, so our alpha, our p-value is sitting right here. Our alpha is sitting right here of 0.01. And as you compare these two, do you notice that this one here, our p-value, is less than 0.01? All right, and there's a phrase that goes along with this. If the p-value is low, right, lower than my alpha, my level of significance, then the null must go. So we're going to take the null hypothesis and we're going to reject it. All right, we're going to reject it. What if, though, let's just say, for instance, what if our p-value was greater than our alpha? All right, I know this is not the case in this particular case, but let's say we had a p-value of 0.0289, or something like that, all right? And in this particular case, look, our p-value, rather, would be bigger than our alpha of 0.01. So if this is the case, if your p-value is high, right, is larger than your alpha, then the null must fly. So we're going to keep, all right, the null hypothesis. So hypothesis testing is all about the null. We either reject it or in my case, I put keep here, but technically the term is we fail to reject. Okay, so this is a reject here if the p-value is low, and if the p-value is high, then the null must fly. What we're really doing is we are really failing to reject. That's what's going on here when I say the words keep. Okay, we're failing to reject. So if the p-value is low, the null must go. If the p-value is high, the null flies. And what that really means is if we reject the null hypothesis, what we're in essence saying is we support the claim of the alternative hypothesis, right? If we keep the null hypothesis, what we're in essence saying is this may be true, therefore we don't have enough evidence to support our claim. Right, so the wording of this is pretty tricky. You've got to get your mind around that as well. But this is how p-value testing works.